So I had always been into fashion, and I always wanted to create something of my own. But it was about a year and a half ago, and I was just kind of sitting in my apartment, and it just kind of came to me. You know, I wanted to create something bigger than myself. I wanted more. And I guess you could say that's the day that I realized my dreams and enhanced reality. Taking inspiration from everybody, whether it be my peers, whether it be people that are higher up than me, whether it be people that live a lifestyle below mine. I just take all that in and look at everything that's going on around me, just being aware of all that and looking at fashion and where it's going now and just seeing how there are really no walls anymore and how people are just able to express themselves at new levels than ever before. Just gives me that confidence in my own creativity and gives me that platform where I'm able to express myself through clothes and through being creative. Like back in the day, in elementary school, middle school, we would color and color books and we would have art class and we would just mess around. Now I'm in a position where I can be an entrepreneur and use that same creativity that I had as a kid in order to create something that I'll be able to, gain a profit off of and, create a following.
Catch a wave on a splish. Take a shot, make a friend, just enjoy the moment.
So, when I first met Sebastian, me and Sebastian have been friends since high school. He was a little kid back when I met him, like 13, 14 years old. But, when he started telling me about his brand, he just kind of struck me as someone who wasn't trying to follow the crowd. And when he explained the brand to me, I was like, this is something that can really click with other people, not just me, him, or his peers, but people who really don't know us as well.
Basically, the Ryder Brand started off as kind of a, not motivation, but more of like a inspiration of me saying to everybody else, look, you don't have to just follow, be sheep, follow everybody around you and say yes to everything. I just wanted to kind of teach people to question everything and just kind of, figure out what you love.
All I want to do is go out trapping with shooters. Wrist so froze, you should see how I maneuver.
Fell into some opportunity and I was able to get some tees created with this design that I came up with. And from there, I put them on the market, started an e-commerce store. People liked that product. And then from there, we just continued to grow. I continued to be able to display my creativity on other pieces, other garments. More connections down the road allow me to expand my catalog and expand my merchandise. And so now we're just at a point where we're consistently trying to find new ideas, new inspirations, and come up with different collections that will appeal to the masses and, grow. That's the main thing.
Like a ghost, I'm pulling up at 3. This car just ain't the same without you here next to me. All I want.
10 to 20 years, I really think that the brand can really take off, depending on the people who support it, depending on the people we can get on board, and maybe just keep working on ourselves. There's no better way to put it. Over time, you're always gonna have those trials and tribulations, but at the end of the day, all we can do is just keep working on ourselves, and we kind of just vibe off each other. If Sebastian messes up doing something, or I mess up doing something, I kind of hold him accountable, and he holds me accountable. So as long as we keep ourselves in check, I think
but you keep on running. You know all of my exes, you think I still do too. I just had to change my
it's
number.
It's truly a lifestyle brand. It's not really, 100% about the clothes, but it's also not 100% about the mindset. It's 100% about embodying both of those things together and using them in your path of, finding what's going to make you successful. Basis laid out of the mindset that goes with the clothing it gives. So say if the clothing doesn't sell well, or if you know, there's a drop in the economy, people aren't able to purchase clothes anymore, that mindset will always still exist. And I feel like a lot of these brands out here, they're just, you know, make stuff that is trendy and get a quick buck off of it, and they forget the whole mission about what they're doing, and they forget the purpose why they started it.
It's hard to focus when a nigga's on it. I've been trying to balance all this on my plate. I ain't trying to be lying to your face. You can do better than I.
It's been a year since I started, but throughout the whole process, I've met a lot of new people. I've been able to see a lot of new perspectives, and promoting the mindset that I've been promoting throughout this whole campaign has allowed me to really see the people who understand what I'm saying. And it gives me that new audience of, wow, okay, so I thought I was the only person talking, but people out here really understand, you know, what I'm saying and the point I'm trying to get across. And, you know, building that following has given me even more confidence, like we spoke about earlier, to be even more creative and add newer things that may not necessarily be the most complex, but they're simple. And remaining with that phrase that the great Leonardo da Vinci once said, keeping it simple is also keeping it complex. So I just am trying to do that and continue to grow and continue to add new designs that people will love.
Yeah. Yeah. Go.
But with me, you know, like to speak everything into existence. And in order to get to the top, I know that I have to come with something different. I have to come with a mindset that a lot of people aren't used to seeing, and something that is just kind of out of the box that, wow, okay, I wasn't expecting that out of this guy. I know that, you know, a lot of people, they have dreams. A lot of people, you know, say that they're going to do something and they love it, and then it ends up just being a fade. With me, it's just, you know, this is what I love to do. Persistence is key, and I'm just going to continue speaking things into existence until I'm at the top and I'm mentioned with the greats.
That's a vibe, that's a vibe, that's a vibe, oh that's a vibe, yeah, yeah, that's a vibe, it's a vibe, it's a vibe, that's a vibe, yeah, yeah, it's a vibe, am I your type, pussy type, maybe I'll spend the night, yeah, yeah, that's a vibe, what's it, vibe, that's the type of shit I like, yeah, yeah, that's a vibe.
Three, two.
I feel like
you are.
I like this little.
Yeah,